Hey, what's up everybody? My name is Jonathan. I hope you guys are doing well. If you're new here, welcome. If you're not new here, welcome back. Today we're gonna be talking about some tips when it comes to shopping for a new Mac. With the release of the 16-inch MacBook Pro, plus the holidays right around the corner, I figured this is a good video to do, especially when I wanna save you guys some money. Now with that being said, some of these things may not be pertainable to your situation. And if that's the case, feel free to add anything to this list down below in the comment section. Just remember, this is not a Mac versus Windows debate, so there's no reason to get offended and go off. Keep it PG and try to remember to help out your fellow viewer or subscriber. So with that being said, let's go ahead and jump straight into this with tip number one. Despite how silly it might sound, tip number one is don't buy a new Mac. Now I know it kind of contradicts the title of this video, but the best way that you can save some money is don't buy a new computer, use what you got, and chances are with this video's sponsor, Clean My Mac X, you can get a little bit more power out of your current Mac. If you look at a Mac like a drain, it all starts to make sense. So when a drain starts to get gook and gunk stuck to the inside of the pipe, the water can't flow correctly. When a Mac has a bunch of junk files and just things it doesn't need on it, then of course it's going to limit its performance, slowing it down and giving you a very unresponsive Mac. So how do you clean a drain? You get some Drano, a pipe cleaner, pour the Drano down the drain, take the brush, loosen up the gook and gunk, and now the water can flow correctly. How do you clean your Mac? It's the same thing. Install Clean My Mac X, then run the smart scan feature. It's automatically going to detect any cache, temporary, or junk files that can be removed. And once all that stuff has been removed, now your Mac can flow correctly. Now, if that's not enough, there's also built-in optimization tools and maintenance tasks that you can run that are gonna help accelerate your Mac's performance, including speeding up boot up times. I'm gonna leave a link down in the description so you can check it out. Who knows what kind of sales are gonna be running for Black Friday and all year long. So make sure to click on that link if you want the most up-to-date pricing. Another thing that you can do to speed up your performance, if you're using an older MacBook Pro with an NVIDIA GPU, you can pop off that back panel and chances are you can upgrade the RAM and the SSD. If you're using an iMac, not an iMac Pro, there's a little back panel that you can pop off and replace the RAM in those computers as well. Now, if you're tech savvy and you're feeling ballsy, you can take apart the iMac Pro and void any Apple Care or Apple Care Plus warranty you have on it, but you can replace the CPU, RAM, and the SSD found inside of iMac Pros. The iMac, you can do the same thing with, take it apart, replace the CPU, and if you have a Fusion Drive model, you can replace that drive as well. And the last thing I wanna talk about when it comes to improving the performance of your current Mac is utilizing your Thunderbolt 3 ports. Now, if you have Thunderbolt 2, don't worry, you can definitely expand your storage, and you could go the eGPU route, but I definitely don't recommend it. But if you have Thunderbolt 3, I definitely recommend doing both. You can expand your storage and get insanely fast speeds, especially if you use something like this. This is a small Thunderbolt 3 NVMe enclosure. You can pick up a Samsung 970 or other NVMe drive with high storage capacity up to 2 terabytes, install it in this enclosure and gain insanely fast speeds. Best of all, it's bus powered, so you don't have to worry about plugging into a wall, and it's going to give you speeds that exceed or match the SSD that's inside your MacBook Pro. Definitely a great option. And when it comes to expanding the capabilities of your GPU, thanks to macOS Catalina and all of the metal acceleration enhancements that came with that update, now using an AMD GPU with your Mac, it's gonna give you a lot of performance gains, especially when it comes to video editing and other things that are going to utilize that GPU. So definitely some great options there. Make sure you look into how you can expand your current Mac utilizing the available ports that you have, because you never know what your Mac is capable of until you try. Tip number two is to get a better understanding of the apps that you use. That way you know how to spec your Mac and you don't overspec and pay for things that you don't need. For instance, if you're an audio editor, chances are you don't need that high-end GPU. However, I would go up on the RAM because 16 gigabytes of RAM is a little bit low. I would go all the way up to 32 or 64 gigs depending on what kind of audio editing you're doing. Knowing things like that before going in and making a purchase is going to save you a ton of money. So make sure you research the applications that you use, because all apps utilize system resources differently, and then base your configuration off of that. Tip number three, don't buy brand new. Chances are you don't need the latest and greatest. When I purchased my iMac Pro, I bought it refurbished from Apple directly in their refurbished and used department. I saved myself a ton of money, still got a great machine, and it's covered under Apple Care Plus. So make sure you check out their used and refurbished department before buying brand new. Chances are in 4 or 5 months, you're gonna be able to find configurations of the new 16-inch MacBook Pro in the Apple refurbished and used department with a substantial discount, and you're gonna get similar performance. And you can also find great used deals at B&H, Amazon, eBay, Newegg, and plenty of other third-party stores where you're gonna save a ton of money and still have the same kind of performance. Tip number four, always get AppleCare Plus. Even if you purchase from a third-party store like Amazon, eBay, or Best Buy, you could still add AppleCare Plus to your product as long as you're buying it brand new and you have that proof of purchase. But if you're buying directly from Apple, you could put AppleCare Plus on a new product, a used product, or a refurbished product from all of their stores. AppleCare Plus will cover your computer from accidental damage and manufacturer defects for an extended period of time versus the standard one-year manufacturer warranty. This is great because you never know what's gonna happen down the road. Now, if you bought a used Mac from a third-party store and you're unable to add AppleCare Plus, that's okay, don't fret. You could use something like SquareTrade, which is owned by Allstate. They're gonna offer similar insurance for a one-time fee for up to 3 years, and they cover pretty much anything, whether it's used or something that's sitting at your house. As long as it's fully functional and you can, you know, provide that it is working, they're gonna cover it. Finally, tip number five, always keep an eye out for different deals and trade-in options locally or online. For instance, at the time of this video, B&H Photo is having a Mac sale, so you can cop a brand new Mac computer at a discounted rate, especially compared to the Apple Store, which they hardly ever do any kind of sales or promotions. If you're looking for trade-in options, Apple themselves will allow you to trade in your current Mac. Chances are they're not gonna give you the price that you're wanting, but it's an easy solution and you don't have to deal with any angry people or people trying to hustle you out of money. If you're looking to sell your current Mac, which is probably how you'll get the most money for it, you could do Facebook pages, Craigslist, eBay, Amazon, and plenty of other markets out there. There's even other stores dedicated to just buying back old Macs. I'll leave a few down in the description if you feel like checking them out. So that's the end of this video. Hopefully some of these tips will help you save some money. Let me know down below if you plan on copping a new Mac for Christmas, for a loved one, for a friend, or are you planning on upgrading your current Mac? Sound off down below. I definitely want to hear back from you guys. Also, what do you guys wanna see when it comes to 16-inch MacBook Pro coverage? I ended up getting the base model i9. However, you know, I'm probably gonna upgrade and get a custom one with that higher end GPU and at least 32 gigabytes of RAM. So there's anything that you wanna see in specific when it comes to that kind of coverage, let me know down below. If you enjoyed this video, consider giving it a thumbs up. Subscribe for more videos just like this, and I will talk to you fantastic people in the next video.